In this video, we'll show you how to change your capillary cartridge coolant tubing. If you would like to change the length of the capillary, you must remove and change this tubing to correspond with the proper capillary length, as indicated in the required equipment and materials section of the relevant application guide. Before you begin, you will need to remove your capillary. This is covered in our video titled Cartridge Rebuild and Capillary Removal. First, you'll begin unscrewing the light blue nut closest to the outlet side of the cartridge. Then, pull out the tubing. Repeat this step on the other light blue nut closest to the inlet side. Be sure to remove the black O-rings and navy blue ferrules from both sides of the tubing. Sometimes, the O-rings will remain in the cartridge after tube removal, and you will need to use plastic tweezers to remove them. Once the tubing has been removed, it should be discarded. Tubing cannot be reused due to the risk of coolant leakage. Next, choose the proper length of coolant tubing to correspond with your capillary length. Then, add the light blue nut so that the nut threads face the end of the capillary tubing. After that, add the navy blue ferrules so that the smaller end points to the light blue nut. Now, add the black O-ring to the end of the tubing. Repeat these steps on the other side of the tubing. Now, you are ready to connect your coolant tubing to the cartridge. Feed the coolant tubing into the cartridge on the inlet side first. Then, feed it into the cartridge on the outlet side. Finally, tighten the light blue nuts on both sides to finger tight. Do not over-tighten. The next step is to rebuild your cartridge. This is covered in our video titled Cartridge Rebuild and Capillary Removal.